My name's Rowena.
And my name's Nathan. We're from Dorset Creative, a digital agency based in Dorset, working on a variety of digital applications, websites and video.
Hello, my name is Estrella. I'm a documentary filmmaker that just started.
My name's Ian Robertson. I'm a freelance filmmaker, specialising in stop motion techniques, as well as live action films like music videos and documentaries and short films.
So what motivates us? I suppose the financial side of things is definitely a key motivator, as it enables us to get better equipment and produce better works, really.
But it's not just, it's not the only motivator, because also we like to inspire our audience through our creative work.
I feel that filmmaking can reach many different aspects of realities that are not easily explained or that cannot really come across that easily through other means of information.
I guess I'm motivated by other people's creativity, so if I see a good film or hear a good piece of music, that really inspires me to make my own stuff.
I think copyright to me is about protecting the expression of the idea. I think the idea, everybody should have access to the idea itself, but I think that you should have your own rights the way that you express it.
I guess I've never seen copyright as a motivation to make my own work, but I do like to think that if you do make something original, then it is your own and you do own it, and it's something that you've produced and no one else could have produced.
Copyright for me is about having your name attributed to your work, and if I want to use someone else's work, I always make sure I attribute them in the work that I'm doing.
Film production is obviously something that is teamwork, so I always have to use someone's work, but it's something that it's always agreed. It's nothing that I'm doing without any sort of authorization.
The video process combines lots of different parts, and we might, for example, break the video down so we have some animation, like a name tag at the bottom that we bought in from somewhere else, and we'll buy the license to be able to use that within our work, and that's reusing somebody else's work.
But also we use lots of music to enhance our videos, which we'll get from royalty-free banks, which we pay subscriptions for.
I don't use other people's work in my own films, generally. I do work off of other people's work when I make music videos. Obviously they give me the track and then I'm making visuals for that track. So I'm working with other people's work. I'm quite happy for people to use my work if they ask for permission and if they're making something new and original out of it. I'd say if they're making a lot of money out of it, then I'd probably wanna, you know how much they're making and maybe get a slice of that. But if it's just for the joy of being creative and being inspired by other people's work, then of course I'm all for that, and I think that's a great idea.
If someone wanted to use my documentary film for their own purposes, I would be happy about it, and I wouldn't necessarily want them to ask me explicitly if they can use it.
I think if someone had to phone me up to ask me to use my work, that's just an extra level of bureaucracy that we don't need. I think it's fine just to credit me at the end and then maybe tell me about it later, which would be an honour.
Trying to put a dividing line between inspiration and copying, I think it's very difficult, because who's to say that two people couldn't have exactly the same idea and come up with the same product at the end, or very similar indeed.
There is this thing that we call intertextuality. We keep making reference to things that we've seen, things that we have read, and I don't think that any filmmaker could make something without having inspirations.
As a filmmaker, I'm always watching other people's films and being inspired by other people's creativity. So inevitably, the final product may seem similar to other people's work, but I think as long as you're not intending to copy someone, then that's a completely natural part of the creative process. If you take someone else's work and then manipulate it into something that's almost unrecognisable to the original piece, do you still have to get permission to use that original piece of work?
Is there a time limit when you want to quote particular films, or when you want to include certain videos? Is there a particular time limit that you can use? And also, do you have to put a particular banner saying that you are quoting it?
If we find a piece of work we want to use within our work, and we can't find the person to gain the copyright consent from, what do we do?
Can we just use it anyway?